G'day one and all, I'm Southpaw Racer. This is a super serious track guide to Queensland Raceway. Finally, thanks to the first ever monthly Patreon poll, we're looking at QR, part of one of Australia's top motorsport facilities alongside Willowbank Dragway. It's popular as a test venue for the Queensland-based supercars teams, though it hasn't hosted a round of that series for a while. And somehow, I don't think too many fans miss it. Because if you load this track up on a Assetto Corsa looking for a driving experience like Phillip Island or Bathurst, you'll find out why this place is called the Paperclip very quickly. Hot lap time, though it's more lukewarm in my case. Smashing up the gears down the start-finish straight, you pass over this huge bump next to pit exit and, you were supposed to start braking for turn one there. That's unfortunate. Rewind and try again. Yeah, this track's become notorious for its bumps. I suppose it needed something to make the layout more interesting. Anyway, fourth gear through turn one, try to feed on the power without fishtailing, and if you nail the throttle, feel free to be proud of yourself for a moment before you realise you've missed the braking point for turn two. This corner is arguably the most important on the track, so it's essential to get the exit right, but with slight negative camber and a constant radius that will catch you out if you apply throttle too soon, it's also the corner that will cause the second highest amount of pain on this track. Which one causes the most? We'll have to wait until the other end of the back straight, which you enter having to upshift. Touring car racing in Australia has used fixed gear ratios for the last 20-something years, with a particular final drive ratio mandated for each individual track on the schedule. The shortest of these final drive ratios was what was used at Queensland Raceway. It tops out a little early, you miss out on a few extra kilometres an hour, but all the slowest turns are then smack bang in the torque and power band for third gear. If you go a click up on the ratio, you'll be able to reach top speed with some breathing room to spare, but then every subsequent corner will be too slow for third gear and too fast for second. Where do you take the compromise? Well, again, they had to use the shortest drop gear, so if you want to be realistic, the desperate pleading from your rev limiter is the signal to begin braking for turn three. What an enigma this corner is. From the first time I drove this track on V8 Supercars 3, what Toka Race Driver 3 was in Australia, it's always stumped me. It seems simple enough. Double apex, tight entry, sweeping exit, and you've got the link road used for alternate configurations to open the exit further. But it's a trap! Don't let it take you in! If you even get to the apex, it's so tempting to just floor it and think the extra tarmac will save you, but don't forget, this is a brutish V8 beast, and those rear tyres will panic at the slightest slippage. Inevitably, you'll spend more time getting wheel spin under control than focusing on a good exit. You have no idea how much I want to say, psych, we're actually doing the sportsman's circuit, and use the shorter layout to end our suffering early, but no, we must press on. My braking point for turn four is this Marshall's post on the right, which... hold on a minute. This is somewhat dangerous, is it not? Okay, there's not many other places you can put this Marshall's post, if we're completely honest. It needs to serve a particular part of the track, the drivers need to, well, see it, and if we moved it to the other side of the straight, then it'd be right in the firing line for the link road that helps form the clubman and sprint configurations of the circuit. This Marshall's post is pretty much in the safest place it can be, all things considered. But imagine for a second, it's lap one, you've got a full field of big loud touring cars coming right at you, and if there's a freak incident at the wrong time, all you've got to protect you is this pitiful polymer perimeter. Not ideal. Anyway, back down into third gear for turns four and five. This complex, a somewhat inaccurate label, is an exercise in delayed gratification. Like with the corner before, in these touring cars, you can't just put the hammer down and sail on through. You have to ease onto the power out of turn four, build up a bit of speed, then lift off, get the weight back onto the fronts, and guide it to the second apex. From there, you are free to power on way too soon and ruin your exit as God intended. There's some proper curbage in this section that rocks your car about when you hit it, which in turn allows you to more accurately judge how far into the weeds you're going. For instance, if you're still thinking about how close and unprotected that Marshall's post is, and completely miss your braking point while desperately trying to make the corner anyway, the curb might send you airborne, a sure sign that you're on your way to the lake in the infield. Fish yourself out and prepare for the final heave-ho of turn 6. It's similar to turn 3, but a little more gentle. You carry a bit more speed on the way in, which means you'll be even further away from the apex you need to hit, wherever that is. I can't pick the line for the life of me. Do you play with fire and run out wide as the track straightens out? Or do you minimize wheel spin and stick to the inside the whole way round, leaving wisps of what might have been in your wake? Either way, this Monza Parabolica that got stuck in the dehydrator is the last corner you have to surmount before the start-finish straight welcomes you with open arms. Congratulations, you've survived. Now go around one more time and reflect. And on reflection, Queensland Raceway is probably the easiest racetrack in Australia to make fun of. The circuit is literally just a giant triple switchback. It's straight, sweeper, sweeper, straight, hairpin, kind of sweeper, straight, hairpin. No elevation change, no interesting landmarks. In a sim racing sense, there's not much that compels you to drive here unless it's on your league's calendar, but that's not giving due attention to why the circuit was built in the first place. I'm not saying it's a bad racetrack. In fact, if you're a spectator, QR is one of the best places in the country you can go. You can see the whole track from any vantage point, and the nature of its layout means it's honestly pretty good for overtaking. The place was actually designed to fit as many long straights and heavy braking zones as possible within their constraints, and it's nice and wide all the way around. For a driver, that's a big positive. And I'd be an idiot to deny that this facility provides a valuable, essential service to the motorsport industry in Queensland. As Thanos preaches, life is all about balance. Not every track can be Mount Panorama. Not every track should be. Sometimes, you need places where drivers can focus on racing each other, rather than the track itself. So, truck on, paperclip, you do you.
Oh, Jesus, what's come over me? A positive end to a super serious track guide? I think I need a cup of tea. Well, this track is mercifully only 3.1 kilometers long, so it's a short trip back to the pits at least. This video was made possible by the wonderful people listed here, and I mean that. Everyone who supports me on Patreon gets to vote on the next Super Serious Track Guide in a monthly poll. These legends voted for Queensland Raceway, as did my Super Serious supporters, Adam Miller, Callum Crayston, Ira Felberg, Jay Kennedy, The Original Sticks, and Thomas Clarendon Blair. You would have seen their names on my car. That's one of my top tier benefits. If you're interested in supporting me and having a say on what track I roast next, become a patron today at patreon.com/southpawracer. The next poll will go up the day after this video is uploaded and only lasts a few days, so be nimble and thank you for your support.